Could one of you explain, first of all, what fMRI is for those in our audience who may not be familiar, and how its developments over the past few years have affected the field of psychedelics?
Analyses are now becoming more about networks rather than distinct modules in the brain serving distinct functions, but rather distributed networks of regions. And they're also becoming more dynamic. So rather than looking at the properties of brain regions or systems on average across a chunk of time, we can look more dynamically at trajectories of brain activity across time. And those analyses are yielding new insights generally in cognitive neuroscience, and new insights about the brain action of psychedelics as well, and a particular finding that is emerging from our more recent analyses is that under the influence of psychedelics, certain hierarchically high level brain networks, and these are networks of regions that host the most important target of psychedelic drugs, a particular subtype, particular serotonin receptor subtype. These networks appear to break down, and novel patterns of functional connectivity appear to replace them, more globally interconnected patterns of brain activity and brain communication. So it's almost as if these distinct high-level networks, some of those that Ruth was referring to, the default mode network involved in internal mentation and imagination, and executive networks and attention networks closely related, appear to break down. Their boundaries appear to break down. Those patterns are sort of skipped over in a sense under the psychedelic, and the brain appears to inhabit a more globally diffuse pattern of brain communication under the psychedelics.